Libraries are no longer safe in Joe Biden's America. My once favorite place to immerse myself in Dana's reading list has transformed into rowdy drug and hookup dens. Across the country, the ladies who tell you to shush have witnessed everything from public sex, people shooting up, and even assault. It's so bad in San Francisco, librarians are now demanding security guards be stationed at every branch. One poor woman found herself standing between a half-dressed man wielding a sharp letter opener and a group of preschoolers.
Now, Fox News is getting dunked on for that segment. And look, to be sure, starting that segment with libraries are no longer safe in Joe Biden's America is a bit of an issue because it's local laws that typically have an impact on public libraries and the conditions within or around the libraries. So that's one thing to keep in mind. They're taking a story and they're obviously using it as a political tool against their political opponent. So I get why people would see that and immediately have a knee-jerk reaction in wanting to dunk on them if you happen to be a Democrat. However, I think that there's actually a point here, and it's not something that we should make a blanket statement about in regard to all libraries throughout the country, obviously. But there are some instances of libraries that have run into all sorts of really serious problems, which has even led to closures, and I have a problem with that. So I'll get to those details in a moment, but first, how was Fox treated or what kind of commentary were they met with? I'll give you a few examples from social media. One person writes, I have not been offered drugs or sex in 12 years of library work and I demand this injustice rectified. Another person says, yes, libraries, notorious nowadays for their debauchery and raucous ragers. Just remember to keep the noise down while engaging in all the sex and drugs at your local library. Now, again, from first glance, and if you happen to live in an area where libraries are perfectly fine, you're gonna see the segment, you're gonna think it's crazy. But there are definitely examples of libraries who have this issue of, yes, public sex, of open drug use, of people who are suffering from severe mental health issues who lash out in a violent way and endanger other people around them. That is a problem that some libraries in some states are experiencing. And I do think it's a serious problem because this is a public service that is funded by American taxpayers, you know, through local taxes and things like that. And I relied on libraries a lot when I was a kid. You know, we couldn't afford a computer, so my mom would drop me off at the library. And thankfully, I had that resource in order to be able to do my schoolwork. And so if this is an issue, it should be addressed. I just hate that it's being used as a political tool by Fox News. And I honestly also hate that on the left end of the political spectrum, Cenk, you have a lot of people who are kind of tone deaf and disconnected from people who aren't wealthy, who don't have high incomes and don't have the same resources that they might have or had when they were growing up. And so they don't understand how serious this issue is for some people in the country.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you.
So look, I'm with Anna on this one on both fronts. First of all, Fox News, I mean, they're hilarious in how they overhype things. Is this an epidemic? I don't think that it's an epidemic raging across the country of wild sex and drugs parties in libraries. So don't overhype, but of course they overhype, okay? And apparently it's all Joe Biden's fault. What does he have to do with the local library in Wisconsin? Come on, guys. But there's no bounds of reason there. And by the way, people have attacked libraries. It's generally been the right wing saying, oh, take the books out of the libraries. We don't agree with those books, etc. So,
or, you know, historically, conservatives just wanted to stop funding public libraries entirely.
Yeah, so, the kids are going to get an education there and then they won't believe our propaganda, right? But it is true, yes, that in some public spaces, there's been more lawlessness and mainly in the blue cities. Keeping it real, that's what we do. We're honest here, right? So, I'll give you a silly anecdotal example. I went on a trip with my friends about 6 months ago or so, and we're in a different part of the state, and it's not a big city, it's a tiny little area, etc. There's a park, and a couple of guys had to use the restroom, and I said, I wonder if it's open. They're like, the guys who did not live in major cities were like, what do you mean? Of course it's open. Why wouldn't it be open? I'm like, none of the bathrooms in public parks in LA are open.
Right.
That's not true, by the way. Half of them are open, half of them aren't. And so, and they're like, that's the craziest thing I've ever heard. There's no reason why they'd be open. I'm like, guys, if you live in a major city, of course they're closed sometimes, because otherwise either homeless people go in, and we get it, they want a shelter, there's a better way to do it, right? Criminals go in, mainly drug addicts that are, you know, in a bad shape, in a bad place, go in. And so that's why they lock them. And so, and librarians do struggle with this in the bigger cities. What are you gonna do when you have this situation? Someone who's high, someone who's got, you know, mental health issues, and they've come in and have, are people having public sex in places like LA?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely, I've seen it. Okay, so if you're on the left, don't deny reality. That doesn't help at all. Like if you say, no, it never happens, you're totally making it up. Well, that's just not true. So let's get to a reasonable answer on and treat them with the severity that they deserve. This is not the biggest issue in America.
No, it's not. But I do want to give you examples, right? Because it's not just based on, you know, a few anecdotes here and there. There are public libraries that have, you know, had to engage mediators or have shut down because of the safety concerns that the workers in the library were talking about. So let's talk about Oakland Public Libraries. They hired a mediator last year to address safety concerns and low morale. Overall, the mediator found that morale within Oakland's libraries is low. Many staffers feel more unsafe than before, unsupported by upper management, and lack the training required to effectively work with people experiencing mental health and other crises. Some also reported experiencing verbal attacks based on their racial, sexual, or gender identity. Then you have Contra Costa County Library. The spokesperson also told News Nation, we are seeing an uptick in incidents at all of our libraries, and it's a trend happening all across the country. I don't know how widespread it is across the country. I can speak to the libraries in major cities in California, though. There were threats to staff and library property. There was damage to staff and library property multiple times, including things being set on fire. Librarians say that they are experiencing things like verbal abuse, racy situations, that's probably the public sex, dangerous confrontations, and people suffering from mental health episodes. In February, the Antioch Community Library in Antioch, California had to close due to crime and the workers feeling unsafe. The county said the closure was linked to repeated dangerous incidents. Some of the concerns include a couple openly having sex in the library hallway and bathroom, police apprehending a wanted suspect using a computer in the teen section, drug use in the library vicinity, car break-ins, and patrons verbally assaulting staff.
Yeah, so look, this is an important debate about what to do with public spaces when we have folks that live among us who have problems controlling themselves, right? It's a normal problem that humanity has, and we all have to deal with it without demagoguing. Unfortunately, the extreme right thinks that there's, you know, orgies in the libraries and get, you know, panic their audience about it. And the extreme left says, no, there is no problem, and they should be able to do whatever they want. I don't know why the extreme left became libertarians, right? But they say no rules should apply, they should be able to do whatever they want in public. That's insane.
Yeah.
So when order broke down in New York City in the 1980s and 90s, I already experienced this because I lived in that area. When I went to school in New York, I remember my parents dropping me off and a guy being completely naked in front of my apartment, and I was uncomfortable because my parents saw that, etc. And I lived in a part of New York that was falling apart at the seams, right? And here we are right back in the same exact situation now today in LA. So I'm going driving to my parents' house, I'm with the kids in the car, and there's a guy who's naked and doing God knows what with his genitalia, right? Mm-hmm. And so the answer there isn't to panic and to beat the guy up or do whatever, right? Some extreme thing that the right wing wants. The answer also isn't, hey, you know what? The mentally ill and the addicted should be able to have public sex and we don't care about your kids or your parents. No, neither extreme is right. The question is, what do we do? And I think the answer is, get people help, but if they can't, if they say, no, I want my freedom, and they don't want the help,
there has to
I don't think that that's the right approach to say, hashtag freedom. That sounds like right winger talk. No, if someone is incapacitated, mentally incapacitated, we have to get involuntarily take them in to help them. Because they're gonna die in the streets. That's what it leads to. You're not helping them by giving them freedom to run around and do extreme things in public.
Yeah, and it's also not fair to people living in that community who help fund these public spaces and are unable to use said public spaces because of the government's unwillingness and inability to, you know, appropriately respond to people in, you know, experiencing these crises. Period. And yeah, I'm not having a conversation about public sex. Okay, like come on.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.